And as you're sensitive to those truths, you are alive unto God. It also makes us sensitive to responsibility, that when the Lord gives us something to do, we do it. When He commands us, we go. The word of the Lord says, be not unwise, but understanding what the will of the Lord is. Now, when the Lord speaks to you through His word, when He says, awake to righteousness and sin not, and you're sensitive to that, and you determine to awake to righteousness and sin not, that's your evidence of spiritual life. Now, there are certain results that accrue from being alive, and they involve your reasoning processes. Here at this point, we want to encourage you to be a thinker in the kingdom of God. God's people are a thoughtful people because they're in the image of God and have received a gospel that is a well thought out, deliberate gospel. You capitalize upon salvation by learning to think properly about it, in faith, receiving the truth of God. In Romans, the 6th chapter and verse 11, the apostle teaches us to reason properly. Likewise, reckon ye also yourselves to be dead indeed unto sin, but alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Now we enter into the realm of practicality here. Reckon yourself to be dead to sin and alive unto God. Reckon in Scripture means proceed on this basis in your reasoning. Contemplate life from this perspective. You're dead to sin and you're alive to God. Now, why the need for an exhortation like this? Simply because it does not seem from time to time like we are really dead to sin and really alive to God. Circumstances and situation seems to contradict this principle. But now God has spoken. Your faith must anchor itself in the Word of God, not in experience, not in circumstance. God has said, you are buried with baptism, by baptism, into Christ's death, and God quickened you and raised you from death and trespasses and sins and made you alive to God. That's the divine assessment of your baptism. Now, you reason along those lines. When you seem too sensitive to sin, reckon yourself. Reason upon this. Say, I am dead indeed unto sin and alive unto God. God said it, and I'm going to believe what God said. When you do this, divine strength is imparted to you, which will enable you to live above sin. There's a parallel to this in some of our Lord's miracles. On one occasion, Jesus healed a man that was a paralytic that lay on a pallet all his life. Jesus looked at this paralytic and said, arise, take up thy bed and walk. The man had not walked all of his life. It was physically impossible to walk. But when in his will he exerted himself to obey the word of the Lord, the divine power that accompanied Christ's word enabled him to stand up and to walk. Now your experience against sin is much like that. The Lord tells you, awake to righteousness and sin not. Go thy way and sin no more. Well, you say, I'm not able to do it. But when your will is vitalized by the Word of God, and when you become determined, I will obey the Lord, divine power is given to you, life is given to you to obey what the Lord has said. Yield yourselves to God as people that are alive from the dead. Romans, the 6th chapter and verse 13 teaches us this. Yield yourselves to God. Submit yourself to Him as a person that's alive from the dead. Your own personal feeling may seem to contradict this. Your experience may seem to contradict this. But if you've been baptized into Christ, and if what God has said is the truth, then you can yield yourself to God. You can submit yourself to righteousness. You can cause your body to serve God rather than sin. You must believe God on these things. Again, the word of the Lord tells us in 2 Corinthians 7:1, cleanse yourself of all filthiness of flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of the Lord. Get out of your life things that are contrary to God. You do it. God won't take it out for you. You've got to get rid of it yourself. To get rid of it, you must have this view that you're alive to God and dead to sin, the real you. See, in Christ, there's actually two of you. There's the person that's not regenerate, the old nature, the part that's tempted. And there's a part of you that is regenerated, that has been renewed, the new man. That's the one you must listen to. And you must refuse to give in to the old nature that says, serve sin, serve sin. Say, I'm alive to God and dead to sin. Reckon yourselves to be this matter. Do not serve sin, Romans 6, verses 6 through 8 says. Do not serve sin. Don't do it. How can you obey that? By reasoning like God reasons. I'm dead to sin and alive unto God. Now let's review briefly what we have learned in this session. It is an arresting truth indeed. We have learned that when we were baptized into Christ Jesus, we were made alive to God. Not a physical type life, a spiritual alertness to the divine will, an ability to respond to God and to please Him. This happened when you were baptized. In the awareness of this, as you know this, receive it by faith, you'll be able to cleanse yourself of things that are displeasing. You'll be able to separate yourself from things that God does not want in your life. It's life that enables you to overcome sin. It's life that enables you to overcome death. Sin will try and assert itself, to be sure, but you must deny ungodliness. The grace of God will teach you this. In Titus, the second chapter, verses 11 and 12, tells us that the grace of God which bringeth salvation has appeared to all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lusts, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present evil world. Now, a person that is alive to God is teachable. The grace of God can properly instruct him how to avoid sin and the snares of life and go happily on his way to heaven. You are now a stranger in this world. I beseech you, as strangers and pilgrims, abstain from fleshly lusts that war against the soul. Now, being alive to God is what has made you a stranger and a pilgrim in the world. If you don't feel at home in the world, if you feel a strangership to this world, if you feel closer to heaven than you are to earth, if you feel closer to God than you are to men. The reason is because you're alive. This is your confirmation. When you were baptized into Christ, you arose to walk in a newness of life, spiritual life, sensitivity to God. I admonish you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ now to walk in the newness of life, to put on all of the advantages that have been given you in Christ Jesus. And dear brother or sister, be not faithless, but believing.